the survey is not. I like the surveys. I like the survey, but they don't necessarily.
That's what she's here for, though. She's, you know, the hostess with the most of it.
Right, yep. She's your helper in that respect. Exactly.
Watching someone else first will help.
Next up is Madeline Westervelt from Santa Fe County with Opa.
Hello, my name is Madeline Westervelt. I'm 14 years old. I'm with Santa Fe County, and today I'm going to be doing a walk in the woods. So I'm going to go over some rules for hiking, some good tools to have, some things you might see, and how you can help real life scientists with citizen science. So some trail rules to remember is that you should always tell someone where you're going, and you should sign into the book at the trailhead. It's important to sign in to the book at the trailhead because it makes you put in information on how many people are with you, what group are you going with. So if you do get lost, please keep that information. You shouldn't pick up anything like rocks or sticks if the sign tells you not to. If there's nothing there saying you can't, you should be fine. But if you find a feather, you should leave it there and not pick it up because of the migratory bird act. Especially with eagle feathers. And if you find an eagle feather, you should contact the BBC because Native Americans and wildlife people are going to use it. And you should always stay on the trail because if you go off the trail, you can get lost, you can get hurt, you can disrupt the animals' habitat. So the trail's there for a reason to stay on. If you're going out, ask three questions. How long will you be out, what weather will it be, and where are you going, so you can bring the appropriate tools to use. Some essential tools you should always bring is a water bottle, a first aid kit, a phone, and a map of the compass. And in the summertime, always remember bug spray, because you cannot want to get it. Some fun tools to have are field guides. Field guides are really good for identifying things, and there are a couple of good. There's a general guide like this one, which has everything in it from trees to birds. It just has everything in it. And then there are some more specific ones like these two, which are just about birds, wildflowers. And they're laid out a little bit differently. This one has pictures over here and then information on this side. Well, this one has the pictures in the front, and then information back. This is called an identification key, which is kind of like those choose your own adventure stories. It asks you, what shape is this leaf? It's this shape, what is it? And so on, until you get to the species. Binoculars are very good for looking at those in color. And when you're choosing up, when you're looking for binoculars, it's best to just choose which one goes with your eyes. Cameras. Cameras, again, they come in all different shapes and sizes, so it's good. You can use anything from a camera on your phone to a big professional camera. But I like these point and shoots because they're small, they're really easy to take a photo with, and they also take a really good photo. And cameras are good for taking pictures of things you might see. Some things you might see are birds. Birds are a pretty common animal. You can see them a lot wherever you go. And to find them, you should stand still and listen to them. And use your binoculars to find new tricks. Some other animals you might see are small rodents like squirrels, chipmunks, and they like more inhabited, they like more popular roads because sometimes people don't walk through them. And if you're near a body of water, you might see some aquatic animals like turtles or frogs, or like I saw in this picture, a blue heron, and they're really cool to see because they're just the same. Plants in the winter time. Our herding seed, they look a lot like fishes too, so having field guides for them is a good thing. Something you might see in the summertime though is carnivorous plants, like this jackknife. And they're really cool, and how they eat, how they're carnivorous is they have inside of them here, because they have this sort of spiky nectar that doesn't smell good to us, but to insects and like flies, it smells really good. So a fly is attracted to the plant, it's stuck inside of it. The insect eventually dies and it separates and the plant absorbs it. Something you might see on a plant is a gall. Galls are made by gall flies in the fall time, and they lay their eggs in there, and then through the winter time and through the springtime, the eggs hatch and they grow and then they come out of the stuff. They're usually on goldenrods, but I've seen them on other colonies, and if you find one in the summertime, you might be able to find this in the kind of colony that's here. That's where they're coming from. Traces. Finding traces will be a lot harder. You're going to have to look closely. So like in this photo, I didn't really see anything at first, and then I saw these three nuts that were kind of cracked open. And then you get some sort of macro. Footprints are fun to find when it's snowy out and muddy out, but you definitely are going to need a field guide for this because sometimes footprints can be just not in the footprints. And if you're near a pond, you might see a beaver tree stump or a beaver tree stick. And they're just so cool to see. We have these little marks there. You can see them. Major journals and apps can help you record what you see. It's fun to look back at what you saw. A major journal can be any sort of notebook. I like to make mine out of scrapbook paper, cardboard, and on the inside, I use watercolor paper. And on the inside, you can draw or you can print out a picture of what you saw. The weather and the place and a little bit about the A naturalist is an app for tracking and identifying anything you see. If you can't figure out what you saw, other naturalists will come onto your website and will help you identify it. Merlin is an app for identifying birds. You put the information in like the size, the shape, the color, and all the apps mentioned in this presentation should be on Google. Okay, yeah, so, or if you just look them up on the website, you should be able to just kind of go ahead and check. My research is on National Audubon Society, Griffith Trees, beautifully beautiful, history letter, which are the trees. Tree finder by the Nature of Our Jobs, bigger tree finder by the Nature of Our Jobs, National Audubon Society, Griffith Trees, Flowers, and History Museum, Richard Anatomy by Peter Martin, Guide to Nature and Nature by W. Stokes, U.S. Fish and Wildlife Services Fish and Site, and Department of Environmental Conservation Fish and Sites. Thank you for listening. Any questions?
This is a gong.
And that leads me right into my question. The gong emitter, is there only one type of insect that does something like that? Or?
No, I don't. Is there only one type of insect that does that? No, I believe there are others. I'm not sure what the species are.
Did you mention them putting up on brushes, I think you said? And I have them on various things.